Vue.js is a progressive framework for building user interfaces. If you go to this official website, you'll see that it's called approachable, versatile, and performant. What does that even mean? So in this video, I'll go over a beginner-friendly introduction of Vue.js and how you can write UIs easily using Vue.js. We are building a blog app, and this is the page for one submission. So basically, this is the part which displays the number of votes or the number of likes the submission has got. So this is a very simplified version. I have one div, and inside that I have two paragraphs. So one of them will show the number of votes, and another will be shown when there is no vote. And then one button which will be used for voting. The UI of this thing is simple. The real magic happens inside the script. So let me go over the script slowly. So first we will get the reference to the three elements. So the button, the paragraph which shows the vote count, and the paragraph which is shown when there is no vote. Then we create a variable called votes. We initialize it with 0. At the start there is no vote. And then call one function called displayVote. So this function is the one which handles the UI logic. It's simple. It checks if the amount of votes is greater than 0 or not. So if there are more than 0 votes, it will show the vote count element. It will hide the no vote element. And then change the inner text of the vote count to show the number of votes the submission has got. And if number of votes is less than or equal to 0, then it basically does the opposite thing. Now when the button is clicked, it first increases the number of votes. Now, as the votes variable has changed, I have to call this displayVote function once more. Because you see, the UI does not know when the inner variable changes. So basically, every time I change this variable, I have to call this function. Because this is the bridge between my UI and my logic. Now, this is not a difficult thing in this small project, but it gets a little bit tedious when you have a large number of components which might change the vote variable. So every time you change this variable, you have to remember to call this function or you will be in trouble. Also, you see, my UI logic is inside my business logic. This is not good. And that's where Vue.js can help us. But before we go into that, let us see how the web page looks. So basically, it looks like this. At the start, there is no votes. As you click on the button, the number of votes changes. Now here observe, as I said before, if I change the value of the votes variable, nothing happens in the UI, because the UI does not know the votes variable has changed. I have to update the UI by calling the displayVote function. So how does Vue.js can help us here? So basically, Vue.js is a collection of a lot of tools. But for the purpose of this tutorial, we will not go over a lot of them. We will just be happy with the introduction. So let us rewrite this app with Vue.js. So first, I will include the CDN script for Vue.js. This you can find from the Vue.js homepage. Now at this point, my webpage has access to Vue.js. Then we will use it inside our app. So first, let me delete everything. We do not actually need this. To start, we first have to initialize view. So I will create a new variable called view and then call new view and then pass in an object. So this object will have a property called EL. EL stands for elements. So here we will pass the ID of the element on which we want to mount our application. So which in my case is this div. Or the div with ID app. Basically, this is the container for my view app. So I will pass its ID. So each Vue.js app has one or more than one data. So this data is basically an object which contains the data. So remember, previously we had a variable called votes. So this votes is now a data. And the good part about this thing is that this is automatically reactive. So anytime you change this votes variable, your UI will also change. Currently my UI does not have access to votes variable at all. So let's see how to fix that. So we write inside my vote count element this. So what just happened here? You see, this double curly braces, this is a special syntax for Vue.js templates. So what it does, inside it, I can access the view data. So my app has a data called votes, which I can access inside here. So basically, whenever you write some expression inside this double curly braces, it will be evaluated in the context of your view app. So now, if you see on my HTML, it displays the number of votes. Now observe this. What happens if I change the value of the votes variable? Did you see that? The UI automatically changed. I did not call any function here. There is no display votes function, nothing. As soon as I change the value of the variable, it automatically changed. So let's go one step forward. How can I hide this paragraph when the number of votes is zero? Or how can I show this element or paragraph when the number of votes is greater than zero? So for that, Vue.js has something called directives. So directives are basically kind of like HTML attributes, but instead they are parsed by the Vue.js. And they supply some extra information to my Vue.js app. So first one is the VIF. So I will write VIF. And inside that I can write a JavaScript expression. Let me write votes greater than 0. So now, whenever votes is greater than 0, this VIF will be true. And only then this paragraph will be shown. And similarly I can have a VELSE corresponding to one VIF. So let me put the VELSE in the second paragraph. So that when this is false, this will work. Let me see. So as you can see here in my UI, I can already see the no votes element being present here. And the votes count has been hidden because the number of votes is 0. Now currently the vote button does not do anything. So let's see how we can do this. So for that I can react to events. So the syntax of events is that I write at and then the name of the event. In my case this would be click. And then inside that I can increase the votes variable. Now let's see. See, as soon as the number of votes changed from 0 to 1, the no votes paragraph got hidden and the vote count paragraph appeared. So this is the magic of Vue.js. Now observe that I am not calling anything. I am just changing the value of the variable. And everything else automatically changes. Now, isn't that amazing? Now let us go one step forward. So imagine I am writing a blog app again. So this time I will have a list of blogs which will be shown on the web page. And I'll see how I can update the list automatically. So let's start. So I will have this app again. I will delete things here. I'll keep the button here. So first I will show the blocks inside the div. For that I will have an unordered list. And inside that we will see how I can get the list of the blocks. So I will remove the votes data and add a blocks data, which will be empty by default. Now here we come to our next view directive. How we can iterate over an array or an iterable object using the vfor directive. So I will write li v for login blocks. And inside that I will print the content of the block variable. So this syntax might be familiar to you if you have used JavaScript for loop. So what it says is that for every element in your block's data, create one li. And I am capturing the current block by using this block variable. And inside the li, I am just printing this element. So currently you will see something like this because this button is obviously broken. So let's fix that. So I'll name it new block. And currently I will write inside it create block. And I'll change it to create new block. Now this thing, I have to create the method. So I'll create also the method inside the view object, but inside a separate property named methods. Oops. So this method will contain a list of methods my function can call. So here I will create a method called create block, and for now I'll keep it empty. So next thing I will do, add another data, which will, let's say, name it new block. This will be a string, and this will basically contain the current block that I am writing. So let me create another input here. And I will use the vmodel directive to bind it to the new block variable. So what does vmodel do? Let me change the name of the button. Create block button. So what does vmodel do? It binds this input to this data. So whenever this data changes, this input will also change. And whenever this input changes, this data will also change. So it is kind of like a bidirectional binding. So now let's finish this function. So whenever create block is called, I will just take the new block variable and push it to my blocks array. Alright, so there should not be a comma here. And as you can see, by default I have nothing in my blocks array, so it's empty. Now when I write something and do it, see, it automatically goes there. I can write as many as I want. So all that without any difficult logic. So nothing, I'm just changing the variables and the UI automatically changes. So this was basically just an introduction to Vue.js. Now Vue.js offers a lot of other functionalities. For example, reusable components, the router, stores, and a lot of other things. So this was just a beginner friendly demonstration of what Vue.js is capable of. So if you like this video, please let me know in the comments. Subscribe, like, share, do whatever you want. And I am thinking about publishing a Vue.js tutorial soon. So stay tuned for that.